Hello sustainable growers, this is Jonathan from Melbourne Aquaponics and today I would like to talk about a solar aquaponics system. So a lot of you are interested into having a setup completely off the grid, which means not plugged to anything, able to run by itself all the time and with the minimum maintenance. And it is completely possible to build an aquaponics setup and to plug it to a little solar panel with a little water pump. And the one that we got here, that's a very small aquaponics setup that I got in my place that I built specially to plug in a solar panel. So the specificity of this setup is that first, it's quite a small fish tank and a small grow bed. And the specificity are the species of fish that I grow into the setups. I only grow species that are able to survive if for some reason I don't have any sun for a few days and the pump stops, because it happens. So depending on the kind of solar panel that you're going to have, you will be able to cover 100% of the time, or if you go for a bit smaller solar panel, you may have some times where, as I just said, there is not enough sun and therefore the pump is off. And when the pump is off, you don't have any change of water, any basically biological filtration. So the fish are going to be able to stay into the same water for a while. So they need to be able to survive to some poor water conditions. When I say poor water conditions, I'm talking about the fact that they need to be able to survive to a high concentration of ammonia and nitrates. When I say high concentrations, it stays between a certain limit. Obviously, if you know that the pump is not working, you're not going to feed the fish, so you need to be aware of the things, right? But what I mean by that is that the fish need to be hardy. So I really recommend, if you have this kind of setup, to use goldfish, carps, all those kind of fish that can stay in very poor water conditions, but also don't need a lot of oxygen, except if you put a little air pump aside. But if you put an air pump, if you plug the air pump, that you are not off the grid anymore, right? You are linked to the power. So if you want to be completely off the grid, you can have a little solar air pump as well. But when there is no sun, if you don't have a big battery with a good stock of electricity, if it's a very light setup, such as this one, you may have a few days without oxygen, without pump, which means that the fish need to be able to stay into the fish tank without any cleaning and without any supply of oxygen. So if you look at goldfish, you know a lot of people are keeping goldfish into a little tank in the house without pump, without anything, and the fish are able to survive just if you just do some water change from time to time. They are able to support a certain quantity of ammonia. So they will be completely adapted to those kind of setups. So now, for example, the setup I have here, I had the solar panel in place for now 3 years and I didn't have any issue with it. It's running by itself. Even the pump is very, very strong. And to be very honest with you, I never really cleaned the pump because I plugged it with a very large pipe. So there is no problem at all. Obviously, the density of fish is quite low. So that's something that is possible. It's not something that I recommend to anyone, especially if you want to go for big production. But then you can adapt the solar panel. So here you will see that the solar panel is a very small 20 watt, and the battery as well is quite small. So everything is holding into this little box that is on the side of the setup, and the maintenance is extremely low. So that's the paradise, this kind of setup. I really like it. So if you want to do the same thing, you can just buy a kit, you know. So you can buy now the kits of the battery and the solar panel, and you need also to have a converter with it. Otherwise, you can build it by yourself. You will find a lot of information on the internet. So that's up to you. I think that's still interesting to see those kind of little setups that you can have without too much troubles, you know, not too much maintenance. And they are really running off the grid, so it's easy. I really like it. So I hope you enjoyed the video. If it's the case, please give me a like and leave me a good comment. And also, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't done it yet. I offer you a free guide to build your own aquaponics setup from the description of the video just below. So get it. You just have to click on the link of the description. It's completely free and it will allow you to build your aquaponic setup in the best conditions possible. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.
Thank you so much for watching the video. I really hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel, and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon, and I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop!